Hi everyone, this is Pastor Nass from St. Paul Lutheran Church in Lake Mills, Wisconsin, here today with another passage about the hope and peace that we have in God. Let's begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Everybody has a limit. That's true physically, that's true emotionally, it's true spiritually too. Physically, I've watched some of the strongest man competitions, or maybe it won't happen this summer, but the CrossFit games are just a little ways away from us in Madison, where you've got people who will, let's say, do a rowing machine for 4 hours straight or lift weights, or they can do a whole lot more than me, but even they, there's a point where they cannot do any more. And same thing for me on a lesser scale. If you put enough weight on the bar, I can't bench press it. If you ask me to go far enough, I can maybe run this far, but not farther. There's a limit. And emotionally, there's only so much patience that people have. Spiritually, there's a point when people start to question God. And I'm wondering if during this quarantine time at home, it's pushing us to our limits. Because sometimes the harder things in life, they show you just how far you can go before you start to lose your strength. And for you, maybe that's how far your patience can go, or how far your trust in God can go, or even physically too, just holding out in a difficult time. And the passage I have today talks about how that's true. Even the people who are the strongest and the fastest, even they can grow tired in life, but God promises He's the one who keeps renewing our strength. The passage I want to share with you today is from Isaiah chapter 40. It's the verses at the end of the chapter. Isaiah wrote this. He, our God, gives strength to the weary and increases the power of the weak. Even youths grow tired and weary, and young men stumble and fall. But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. The passage talks about kids having energy and young men being the ones who don't usually grow tired. And from what I've seen, that's true. My kids have way more energy than I have. And there's a reason that this time of year, usually it's the high school kids who are playing sports and not me, because they're the ones who seem to be able to just keep going and going and going. But even kids get tired. Even those young athletes, they eventually run out of energy too. And what about the rest of us? How are we to keep going in life if even those who are the youngest and the most full of energy sometimes get tired? God's answer is that He's the one who renews our strength. And the picture is a beautiful one, isn't it? That just like eagles sometimes flying over Rock Lake, they soar on the wind currents and seem like it's just effortless for them to just keep circling and flying all day long. God says that those who hope in Him will renew their strength like that. Not that you won't grow tired as you trust in Him, but God is able to keep you going through life, because in the end, the energy and the strength doesn't come from you. It comes from Him. And so if you today are just feeling tired, and not just because you didn't sleep enough last night, maybe that's the reason it is, but if you're feeling tired today, whether that's physically or emotionally or spiritually, know that as you trust in God, He promises to give you the strength and the energy to keep going, whatever it is you face today. And so let's say a prayer to God, asking Him for exactly that. Lord God, we know that You love us. You sent Your Son to die for us. You promise that You have forgiveness for us and life forever in heaven. And so I pray today that just like You've kept all those promises for us, that You'd keep that promise You make in Isaiah. That when we get tired, You would be the one who gives us the energy and the strength to keep going in life. I pray for all of us, especially as we keep going through this time when we're apart, when we have to stay at home. Give us what we need each day to love those around us, to keep persevering in our faith, to keep going trusting in You. So I ask all that in Jesus' name. Amen. So go into the rest of your day today with the Lord's blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look on you with His favor and give you His peace. Amen.